Hi guys, in this tutorial I will be showing how to draft a notch collar jacket. This tutorial is going to be in two parts, the drafting and the cutting, while the sewing tutorial would be in a separate video. So this tutorial is dedicated to the drafting process of this jacket that I made. If you want to learn how I did this, then you should see this video up until the very end. Now let us jump into the tutorial. To begin, these are the materials I will be working with. I am using this fabric. I don't know the name exactly. It was given to me by my mom to make this jacket for her. And I also have this lining piece that I would be using. I've got my pattern paper and I've marked out my lines. And we are going to be doing the alterations together. This side is for the front, while this side, the back part of the jacket, will be drafted upon it. So guys, for clarity, I am labeling my lines. I've got a chest line, bust line, under bust, the waist line, and the hip line, or the full length of this jacket. Also, I marked out about 2.5 inches away before I started drafting out the front. This would enable me to draw my lapel collar. Next, I would be placing a quarter of my horizontal measurement. First, I will be placing a quarter of the bust measurement on the chest line, a quarter of the waist measurement plus 1 inch that allowance on the waistline, and a quarter of the hip measurement on the hip line. I will connect all the points together. After that, I am going to be drawing in my armhole. Also, I would be drawing in my neckline. My neck width is 2.5 inch because I'm working on a jacket. The neck depth for the front would be 3 inches. I'll connect this into a round neckline. The next thing I'll do is to draw in my dart. I added 1 inch for dart allowance. After that, I will be getting the midpoint of the shoulder slant and connect it to my dart. I want a little bit of fitting around the underbust, so I would mark 1 inch inward on the underbust line and draw in my underbust curve this way. I'll connect that to my waist dart. This jacket would be having a 1 inch overlap, which would serve as the button stand and the button hole. So I'm just marking 1 inch away from the center front. Next, I would be determining my break point. Every jacket has a break point, and that is where your center front would overlap. For mine, I'll be going for a depth of 7.5 inches and I just connected it downward. I will also make sure my neckline sits into the 1 inch overlap. It is now time to draw my lapel. First, I'll be marking 1 inch outward. You can mark more than this, it just makes your lapel bigger. Next, I'll be using the curvy part of my pattern master to create the curve of my lapel, making sure it ends at the overlap. I want my lapel to be a little bit raised, so I'll be marking 1/2 inch upward. And from that 1/2 inch, I'll be creating a slant that ends at that 1 inch. So my lapel is a little bit raised by 1/2 inch. In order for me to draw my river collar, I would need an extra paper. So I'm just attaching an extra paper to my shoulder slant. For me to accurately draw my river collar, I will be needing the measurement of the back. So I'm just going over to draw the neckline for the back. I use 1/2 inch for the neck depth and I'm measuring what I have there. I think I had about 2.5 or 2.8. Next, I will be drawing a line that is perpendicular to the shoulder slant. Then I'll mark my measurement. I had 3 inches. So I mark 3 inches there. I'll also square in another line. This line would be for the width of the collar. And I'm going for a width of 2.75. Next, I'll be coming down to my lapel and I'll be marking 0.75 inch inward. Then I would angle my tape and raise it upward a little bit and mark 1 inch outward. I would rule a line. It's going to be a slanted line. Then I'll connect my width of the collar up onto where my line stops. Also, I'll be marking 1/2 inch outward from my collar, and I would curve that into the length of the river collar this way. This will help the collar sit into the back neckline. I'm just going over to label. I've got the river collar and I've got the lapel. So guys, for now, I am done with the front. I would proceed to the back and just do the alterations. First thing I will do is to mark my horizontal measurement, which is the bust measurement, the waist measurement plus that allowance, and also the hip measurement. I'll connect all those points together. After that, I'll be drawing my armhole. I will also mark my darts. Next, I will divide my shoulder slant into two and connect to the dart. I've got the center back and the side back. I'm going to be adding 1/2 inch to the center back right on the pattern. Before going over to trim off my pattern, I want the center front to be slightly curvy. So I'll be marking about 2 inches upward from the center front. Then I would create a curve in this manner. So this is how my front is going to look like. Next, I'm going to be cutting out my patterns and I'll be showing us what they look like. I am done cutting out all of my pattern pieces. I've got the center front, the side front, I've got the river collar, which will sit into the lapel. I've also got my center back and side back. So guys, for the river collar, this mark right here is the part where the river collar and the lapel matches up. Okay, but I want it to match up with the 1 inch button extension. So I'll just alter that to make sure that the lapel, the river collar would sit into the lapel at the 1 inch button extension. Okay, so you can see it's this way. It is now time to cut. To cut, I'm going to be placing my fabric on fold into two. Afterwards, I'll place my pattern on it. I'm starting with the front. I would mark all of the necessary seam allowance and also add up my hemming allowance too. After that is all done, I'll proceed to cut this out. I'll also make sure that I notch all of my push-up points like the bust, the underbust, the chest line too, to enable easy sewing. I am done cutting, guys, and here is what I've got. This is my center back right here. I've got the main fabric and also the lining. I have my side back also. I've got the main fabric and also the lining too. Likewise for the front, this is the side front. I've got the main fabric and the lining. And for the center front, I've got the main fabric. And the main fabric is also the lining too. This is because of the lapel. I've also got my river collar. I cut out 2 fabric pieces for this. I didn't use the lining. I used my main fabric to cut out the 2 pieces that I need. For my river collar, I made sure I notch the part of the collar that sits into the lapel. Very important. I also notch the part that sits into the shoulder slants, also equally important. We have now come to the end of this tutorial, guys. In my next video, I'm going to be sharing the sewing process. If you found this tutorial helpful, please give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed, kindly click on the subscribe button, and I will see you guys in the next tutorial. Goodbye.